These are FBI composites of two of a possible four suspects, both white men, one in his 20s, the other in his 30s. The FBI also thinks that someone may have seen something.
We'd like for the public, if they know anything or have seen anything, and people could have seen these individuals anytime within the past 2 or 3 weeks in this general vicinity or even up into here.
Here is the Village Retirement Center on Old State Route 74, where one of the cars used in the robbery was recovered last night, and where the FBI says an accomplice may have been waiting. Channel 9 has also learned that the thieves made off with $400,000 to $500,000 in cash. We've also learned that the two cars used in the robbery were stolen. One of them, the Jeep Cherokee, taken from the Hampton Inn parking lot here on November 11th. The other one, the white minivan, was taken from the Holiday Inn right across the street just 3 days later. Special Agent Tolan says the crime appears well planned until one of the robbers opened fire with a semi-automatic rifle.
It could be an amateur or it could be a professional. We don't know. But it's not a wise thing to do to fire a weapon directly into the ground, not far from your feet, because on a hard surface such as that parking lot, the bullets can go any direction.
FBI agents told us today that surveillance cameras inside of the bank may have caught a glimpse of the robbers. The film is being analyzed. Agents also say the suspects made another big mistake in that they didn't wear masks and bystanders got a good look. Brinks is now offering a $50,000 reward for the arrest of the people responsible for the largest robbery in tri-state history.